Thank you very much. Thank you, lovely. Yes, here we are on the Games Master oil rig again. The salty spray licking against our legs with nothing but our protective hoods for comfort. But we can all take warmth and cuddliness from the man who sets the challenges, the Games Master.
Greetings and welcome on board the Games platform, especially to those of you who are staying offshore for the first time. I do hope you're not feeling too homesick. And talking of sick, I trust you haven't already eaten, because my first challenge is quite right to bring it straight back up. You must complete lesson two of the skydiving course on pilot wings. After being dropped from a considerable height, you must control your descent so that you fall through a series of hoops before negotiating your final approach to the landing pad. As a concession, you will be allowed a parachute. One tip, don't leave it too late to pull the ripcord. Best of luck.
Now, for these particularly tricky aerial hijinks, we've brought in a brother-sister combo. Please welcome Emily and Michael Gleave. Welcome, Emily. Welcome, Michael. Now, Emily, why is it that more boys play video games than girls?
Because girls have got more sense than to waste their money on computer games.
You're not supposed to say that on this
What's program. What's the
Now, Michael, what are your friends going to say if your sister beats you?
I don't know, but they're going to cuss me.
They're going to cuss you?
Yeah.
I don't think we did that up in Scotland. Never mind, Michael. Right, well, we wish you all the best of luck, OK? I think, Emily, if you'd like to go first, and Michael, if you'd like to just linger behind your sister in your lovely colourful top there, we'll get ready to play. And joining me for a spot of commentary is Frank O'Connor from Super Action. Welcome, Frank.
Pleased to see you again, Dominic.
All right, Frank, now, we've got two buoyant competitors here. Do they need any tips from us?
Take it gently. Slow, gentle movements is the key. And watch out when you get closer to the ground.
All right, then. Just to reiterate the challenge, both our competitors have one skydiving attempt to register the most points possible. Emily, are you ready?
Yes, Dominic.
Then off you go. Okay, now here we see Emily dropping here. Here's the first of these rings, Frank.
Yeah, I mean, one technique is just to stay where you are and hopefully go through as many rings as possible. But if she uses slight tilts and bends, she can get through all the hoops.
Okay, she's past one ring, she's through the second ring.
Yeah, she's come through the third ring. Now the next one should be in a slightly harder position. There it is.
So just that, there's the slow, gentle movement she was
talking
about.
Yeah, she's going to have to tilt up. She's done it, yeah.
Nice one, four rings. This one more
Looks
ring.
Like she's going to get the fifth. Well done.
Oh, lovely, lovely. She was diving a little bit there. Do you how much control do you have over your man?
You can get him to go roughly where you want, but it takes a very long time.
Okay, then we saw the screen prompt push it open. The parachute is now open. Now she's got to try and get to that bit in the middle. How well is she doing?
She's doing reasonably well. I wouldn't have opened the parachute as quickly as that, but she's going to be okay, I think, if she's just careful.
Okay, she looks like she's going away on the runway.
Yeah, that's one of the techniques is just to swing back around at the last minute and then you'll come in really quickly on the target. And I think that's what she's going for.
Okay, so here we go, Emily. She's only 240, 30 feet off the ground. She's descending quite rapidly. I hope she isn't. I don't know what she's doing here. It's going to be a very, very late swing indeed here.
No, I think she's doing it quite just about right. If she turns now, she should land straight on the target.
Oh, this is a nice one. Is she good? Oh, no, she might land in the water. Oh, no, she's done it. Great landing, but perhaps could have landed in a higher point scoring ring there. But let's see Emily's points. Emily has a total score of 70 points. Emily, would you like to make way for Michael now? Michael, are you ready?
Yeah.
Then off you go. Here he's falling down towards the first of these rings. He's staying nice and still.
Yeah, it's the best policy to begin with. Just get a nice rate of descent and keep in the centre.
And he's through the first ring. Here he comes down to the second. And he's through the second ring with relative ease. This is looking good.
He's going to have to turn for the fourth ring, though, and that's the tricky part. Okay, he's managed that quite well, yeah.
Diving a little bit here, Frank. Oh, he's correcting himself, though. Oh,
just missed. Swung past just
it.
Missed.
He's trying to get around. Oh, no, he's just made the fifth one. But he can still make the point up if he hits the target,
Frank. If he hits the target dead on centre, he can quite easily beat that score. But if not, it could all end in tears.
Okay, here he comes. He's got a rate of descent too great. He's going to slow it down a bit. Can he slow it down in any way?
He can slow it down a little by just sort of drifting in the direction he's going. But if he pulls down, he falls faster, which he seems to be doing at the moment, which is a bad move at this point.
Okay, here he comes. He's got a watch. He's running out of altitude here. Oh, he's running out of altitude now, but he might just make it into the centre there. This is going to be close. He's going towards the centre. Is he going to make it? Is he going to make it? He's into the centre. He's done it. He's got there. He's got there. He was just drifting off. Oh! Just went over the main point rings there. Oh! It was very, very close there. He didn't quite beat Emily Scott. He got 59 points, which means Emily is tonight's winner. Close contest that was. Michael, there was only 11 points in it. It was very, very close. Where did you maybe miss those couple of vital points?
I thought I was going to win, but the wind blew me off a couple of the rings, so I was a bit unlucky.
You were a bit unlucky. Are you going to have a rematch when you get home?
No, we don't have a Super Nintendo.
Well, you may not have a Super Nintendo, but tonight, Emily Glebe is the winner of the Games Master Golden Joystick. And now some lovely leisure software comes under the beady eye of our hand-picked pundits in this week's reviews. This week we send Auntie Marisha into orgiastic rapture as we look at gory games. First up on the Mega Drive, hockey mask wearing, blood-curdling, mucus-flying, vomit-inducing action with Splatterhouse 2.
The gore effect has been turned up for maximum effect. You've got bloated babies, skinless zombies, chainsaws and spears of death. Love it.
Not very much thinking, not very much variation in any of the levels, and generally I just don't see the point.
Gameplay really lets the game down at the end of the day. It's just not involving enough.
Next, on the PC, escape from the haunted house your japster uncle has left you in Legacy.
Legacy is an absolutely massive game that is going to take you weeks, if not months, to finish.
The monsters that you come across as you walk through the house are really nasty. It's really good fun.
Severed heads galore, splattered arms, lovely.
Finally, on the Game Boy, cower in fear, shake till you hurl, and wake up sweating from the nightmare that is Barbie.
Obviously, it's not going to be a game for everybody, but if anyone feels okay about buying a Barbie game, then they're probably going to enjoy it.
I suppose it was a good idea to try and get girl gamers interested, but doing it that blatantly, it's just not going to work.
Whoever came up with this idea should be shot.
Now it's time for this week's feature. A handheld enters the world bare and unclothed, just begging to be dressed up in all kinds of technical frippery. With Christmas not too far away, we give Games Master's top 5 add-ons. In at number 5, who needs batteries when you have the Solar Boy? An unfeasibly useful device. Slot the Game Boy snugly into its protective sheath, add generous amounts of daylight, and environmentally friendly game playing hours are yours. Four, add a few racks to your Game Gear library with the Master Gear Converter. Put a Master System game in, gently caress the whole shebang into the Game Gear, and you can now play Master System games handheld style. Making the number 3 spot its own, the Handy Boy. Pin back the amplifier flaps, gently coax out the magnifying screen, and press on the joypad. Now you can enjoy a fuller sensory experience with the only Game Boy with built-in wings. In the runner-up spot, the Sega TV Tuner. This slots into your Game Gear's rear, and if you liberally extend the aerial and have a precocious fiddle, you should get rampant television satisfaction, meaning you need never miss those Open University double bills again. But in the premier position, youthful yuppies give a hearty hurrah for the Workboy, an amazingly educated contraption which turns your monochrome mate into a Filofax extraordinaire, with everything from a calculator to a database for all those irritating facts. The Workboy will be launched at what is possibly the biggest gaming accessory of them all, Gamesmaster Live, a 3-day exhibition at the Birmingham NEC on the 4th, 5th and 6th of December. To book, ring the Birmingham NEC on 021-780-4133. Don't forget to mention if you're in the Gamesmaster Club, because we've got special rates for all members. So, a bumper bag of goodies there tonight. Well, the helicopter's arrived, replete with supplies and tonight's famous bloke. So, for the celebrity challenge, let's go over to Gamesmaster.
I think we're going to have a lot of fun on this next escapade. The game is Dyna Blaster. 5 little men run around, dropping bombs and trying to blow each other up. You should be aware that the number of bombs that can be dropped at any one time and their firepower can be increased by collecting icons along the way. Let's hope you've got what it takes.
So, a 5-man gaming orgy awaits us, and I'm very pleased indeed to welcome 5 of the swoonsomest stars in music. Gary, Mark, Robbie, Howard, and Jason, take that! Good to see you. All right, Hannah. All right, Mark. All right, Gary. Okay. Right, boys, now I know that all of you is like a little waggle now and again, but come clean, who is the best games player in Take That?
Definitely me. No,
obviously
definitely.
Me.
It's me.
It is me.
I'm the worst.
Well, it's funny, Robbie, because I actually read that you can beat Danny Minogue's high score on Tetris. Is this true?
She doesn't find it funny, but it's the truth.
But it is the truth. Okay, well, if you at home want to find out who is the winner out of all of Take That, join us after the break. And you've joined us at a very tense moment indeed. We have all 5 members of Take That here about to attempt Bomberman. Now, they all seem like really good mates in real life, but at the end of this game, there's only going to be one of them standing. With me in the commentary box is Sega Pro's very own golden boy, Dave Perry. Welcome, Dave.
All right, Dominic.
Now, Dave, any tips you can give the boys for this game?
It's very, very simple. Mainly, don't get trapped in corners and use a lot of thought. Game takes a lot of thought.
Okay, then. Right, lads, are you ready? Okay then, off you go. Okay, quickly for the audience, Robbie is white, Gary is green, Mark is red, Howard is blue, and Jason is black.
Basically, the initial idea of the game is you press your fire button, it drops a bomb, that bomb then blows away the piece of wall that it's adjacent to, or the player if a player gets in the way.
Okay, so you've got to keep out the way of the bombs.
Often when you blow away the pieces of the wall, you'll find some power-ups, like those. They look like big blue cherries, you pick those up, the more the blue bombs you pick up, bombs you can lay.
Oh, we've just lost one of the Take That. That was green.
Green Ken's
That's
gone already.
Gary. No, Gary's gone already. The lead singer's gone. Okay, we're just laying bombs here. We've still got 4 to take that in.
Laying bombs a little bit mindlessly at the moment, aren't we?
Maybe they're playing for power-ups
there
here,
we go.
Dave.
That little flame power-up that White Ken's just gone for, that makes his bombs twice as powerful.
That's Robbie, my favourite, who I went for at the start.
Blue Ken's gone.
Blue one's gone. That's Howard. Howard is out of this game. We've just got Robbie, Mark and Jason left.
Right, oh no, it's going to be a big bombs.
Oh no, he's
He got That's red Ken.
Mark is gone.
Now it's a stalking game.
Robbie and Jason.
It's a stalking game now. It's all about thinking and trapping your opponent.
This is getting very tense here. The crowd's going on. He's dead. So Jason's dead and Robbie is the winner. Some game. Before we go on to the winners, I must have a quick word with Gary. Now listen, Gary, what happened? I mean, for a while I thought there was only 4 members that take that.
Oh, listen, I just don't like the game, you know.
Now, Robbie, I tip you to win. You know the prize you're getting. What does it mean to you to win the Games Master Golden Joystick?
I can't sum it up in words. I'm getting so emotional now. There's so many people that I want to thank, but most of all I want to thank my parents. This is for you.
Okay, well, let's move on the presentation. And let's have a big round of applause for Robbie, who's won the Games Master Golden Joystick! Okay, let's have another big round of applause for today's guest. Take That! Okay. After that hectic action, here's everybody's favourite agony uncle with a tip or two in the consultation zone.
Hello, Games Master.
Welcome to the helipad. How can I help you?
I'm finding Thunder Force 3 very difficult. Is there any way you can make it easier for me?
There certainly is. During play, pause the game, then press the following combination on your control pad. Up 10 times, B twice, down twice, B 6 times, and A once. Now, when you unpause the game, you'll be equipped with the full arsenal of weapons.
Thank you.
Glad to be of service. Who's next?
Hello, Games Master. I'm finding the Addams Family very difficult. I'm wondering if there's any tips to make it easier.
Try entering the password 11111 at the start of the game, and you'll begin with 100 lives. If you can't complete the game now, there's little hope for you. Who's next?
Hello, Games Master. I'm James Bond 2, Robocod. I've heard there's a cheat for infinite lives. Could you tell me what it is, please?
Of course. I'm rather partial to this one. From the start, go right and enter the first door that you come across. Once you're inside, go to your right. And just after the second set of spikes, you will see five objects. Collect the object in the following order. First the lips. Then the ice cream. Then the violin. Then the earth, and finally, the snowman. You will notice that the first letters of these objects spell the word lives. You now have an infinite amount of them.
Thank you.
That rounds off tonight's tater-tates. But if you need assistance, you know who to ask.
So, after that veritable bevy of tips, it's time for tonight's final game foray. And it's the third of our special Curly Challenges. What can I say about this man? In his hands, a joystick is a weapon. The undefeated Sega champion, Danny Curley! Now, Danny, last week, Warren Brazier held you to a draw. So how confident do you feel this week?
Well, my luck's going to run out one day.
Okay, well, we'll see if it's tonight. So, if anybody fancies their chance on any Sega game, please put your hands up now! Okay, let me see, where is it? Oh, yes, the guy there, a lovely purple Maroonie top one. If you'd like to come on down, sir, give a round of applause for tonight's challenger! So what's your name?
Jeff Galliers.
Jeff Galliers. So what's the challenge for Curly tonight?
It's Arch Rivals.
Arch Rivals. Oh, Curly. So Arch Rivals, a bit of a basketball game there. Are you confident?
Well, I've played a couple of other basketball simulators, but not this one.
Okay, well, it could be a very interesting competition. If you'd like to sit yourself down, gents, we'll get ready to play. And joining me in the commentary position tonight is Dave Rimshot Perry. Welcome, Dave.
All right.
Okay, now, how do you rate this game? Well, what's the general tactics they've got to use?
It's to be played dirty. It's to hit, to lunge, to do whatever you can to get the ball in the net. It's good fun.
Okay, so it's the first of 20 points. Are our two competitors ready? Then start the tip-off. Okay, so actually, Danny's in the blue playing from right to left, and Jeff is in the red playing from left to right. Oh, my word, what a
instant
shot.
Is that three points?
Well, they've kind of got their own particular favourites here, Dave. Some of them are chanting for Colley, others are chanting for Jeff.
There's another one. Beautiful slam.
Beautiful slam.
Beautiful slam.
From Jeff, so it's a first to 20 points. Long shot attempt by
Colley. Oh.
Jeff's weaving about
Jeff's
here.
Weaving.
Tries a three-point shot. Ah,
lovely. Beautiful, straight in.
5-3 to Jeff.
Jack Nicholson coaching that team, see, that's right.
Oh, he's punched them
back. That's a long one.
That's
close.
Oh,
conveniently bounces back into play.
Curly's picked it up, he's coming in.
Go on,
he tries
Danny.
A long floating shot.
Oh,
and it's
slammed it.
5-0, draws the
slammed it from about 30 feet out.
Okay, so Jeff tries a long shot there.
The
oh, rolls around the rim.
There's
there.
A rim shot.
But he's got the rebound, tries it, and
beautiful.
He rebounds it.
Beautiful again, Vinny.
8-5. to Jeff.
Come on, Danny.
He's got it out there. Connor's got to get his punches in, Dave.
There he goes.
That's another one in for Jeff.
Got to remember, there's no point trying to play this for skill. You've got to hit out.
That's right. It's 10-5 and it's the first of 20. So Connor's got to get his skates in.
Beautiful long ball.
Oh, he's trying to sit. Maybe he's tried a long shot. It's still a 2-pointer. Oh, it's in there. 10-7.
I mean, this game might be won by 2-pointers, you know. The 3-pointers don't always go in.
That's right. It's because he's not nice enough to get a lot
of
points.
Face for nothing, smacking his own players.
Yeah. Oh, no, he tried to dive, but he missed it there. He's all over the place. 12-7 to Jeff.
12-7. There we go.
Oh, double
going
pressure.
Up on
here comes Scully. Once again, nice and close. Get this 2-pointer in. Oh, yes, it's in there.
So he tried to block the shot, but actually pushed
tough.
It into the basket.
That's right. So it's quite tough to get it right.
Work
oh, he's tried to know. Oh,
beautiful.
And very, very audacious 3-pointer shot from Jeff.
He's got to keep the ball off Jeff now because
he's got to go. Oh, he sent the 3-pointer. Oh, unlucky there. But he's got it back. He tries another 3-pointer.
Yes.
And it's in there.
Yes.
15-12 to Jeff.
No time for fitness.
Oh, no. Diving lunge didn't quite work. Another diving lunge in his own player. Oh, and it's in there. 18-12, one more score and Jeff's won the match.
Hopeful.
And Colin's hopeful, but he can get a rebound. How's he going to get it?
He can get in there for the rebound. There you go,
rebound.
Get that one
inside.
In.
Another 3-pointer. Oh, beautiful. Yes, 18-15. He's tried a long shot, that's going to be a whistle.
Manchester
but
kiss.
It's a Manchester kiss. He might get a rebound,
beautiful.
He's got a rebound.
Yes,
it's in there.
It is. 18-17, this is tight.
18-17, probably just needs a 3-pointer.
There's only 30 seconds on the clock.
And Jeff needs a 2-pointer. Here comes Jeff now. He's passed
he's
the back.
He's playing possession. He's making sure he can...
Here comes
oh, that
Jeff,
should
he
be in.
Up, he shoots.
That should be in.
He's
yes!
Lost.
Yes, it's Jeff.
Jeff has beaten
Curry's been
Curry.
Beaten. He's been beaten. Unbelievable.
So, thank you. Thank you. So, commiserations, Daniel. You said it had to happen sooner or later.
Yeah, it was a close match, but at the end of the day, he won.
Oh, well, bad luck, Daniel. Now, Jeff, congratulations. You've beaten the great man himself. What was the difference between you two on the end of the day?
Planning. I had to choose a game that I didn't think he'd played before in my head, obviously.
All right, well, Jeff, not only do you have the prestige of beating young Daniel, you are also the winner of the ultimate gaming accessory, the Games Master Golden Joystick! The dinner gong, which means it's supper time here on the holiday camp. My appetite's been whetted by Auntie Marisha's red snapper. Yours can be whetted by the prospect of two World Wrestling Federation legends on next week's show. British Bulldog will be here and he'll be joined by her suit red...